This is Yohhamgambal. We're back to playing Infamous Second Sons. Last time we Reggie was killed. We were after Hank. Unfortunately, we let him go. So now we're just going after Augustine.
It has come to my attention that the bioterrorist Delson Rowe has begun another rampage. His past terrorist crews have resulted in the deaths of hundreds of loyal D.U.P. guardians and our fellow Seattleites.
Look at that, the people know. Can't lie to the people, Augustine, even though you can.
Good people of Seattle,
all right, let's get over there.
Do not allow Delson Rowe to continue his murderous, bloodthirsty rampage. Delson Rowe has already killed hundreds of us. Maybe a neighbor, maybe even a family member. Delson Rowe has murdered countless numbers of my bravest men. D.U.P. soldiers who gave their lives.
Well, if I was evil, then yeah, but I'm not
Don't
evil.
Don't let their sacrifice be in vain. Delson Rowe must be brought to justice. Whatever.
No, you got it backwards, Augustine. These people have seen us both in action. They want justice. It won't be my head on the.
We gotta get to the tower. This is it, Del. Once you shut the defenses down, there's no turning back. So what's the plan? Conduit? Gonna take her alive? Show the world what she's done? Or just kill her for what she did to Reggie?
We'll expose her because it's a good guy thing.
Time for the world to see what you really are.
It'd be a little weird to be do the evil option after all this. Be a little dark.
Okay, I can work with that. Even
this wasn't that really well protected. I found it really easily. I thought Hank said it was super well protected. Well, to be fair, he was probably lying to get me trapped. To get Delson trapped. I don't know why I said me. Delson and I are different people. Alright, they can't see me, so I'm gonna go ahead. Sneaky-da-doo-dah. Come here, baby. Can I get one more? Yes, I can.
Let's get you. These guys are everywhere.
I know, they are always everywhere. I don't think you have to get all these guys, but I'm doing it anyways. And then there's one last, ooh, damn! I don't know what happened there, but that was cool, dude. My angel, like, Kazakami'd him. I didn't know they could do that. That's cool. You're still, damn, you are a toughie. Alright, let's go ahead. Get some smoke. And whoop, here we go. In we go. Nice. Whoa! Let's see, can't
That's
open
the
that
setback.
Up. And here is the last tracker.
Hey, D, saw a trail of bodies over in Pioneer.
That's all of
thought
them.
Of you and followed them. Hope you don't mind.
Ooh, wow. Oh, there's Fetch. That looks so cool, the way it looks. Damn. Guess I'm just waiting. Or did I fall?
Happy
no,
to
I'm
see me.
Waiting.
I had that covered,
hey,
you know.
Oh, I know, but the
Damn,
hell.
Damn, that's
did.
Quite the jump. I can't do
so
that.
This means you're along for the ride.
You can.
You could have gotten up here a long time
in the
ago.
World
what the
and
hell?
Knock down dragon? Wouldn't miss it for the world. There you go. More
right,
smoke,
so gotta,
boy.
She's got to open the pathway for us because we can't do it ourselves. Which is fine, I guess. Whatever, but it's not even that much rubble. That's blocking it. But it's what it is. Come on. Hey, I see you. Yeah, Fetchy's got that cool biodome attack or whatever. Oh, sorry. It's pretty cool. Thanks for that Kamehameha. Oops, let me try again. I wasn't ready. Whoop! I like that angle. It's a pretty cool angle.
I think I can.
Oh, jeez. You certainly can, Delson. Whoop! Let's get a little smoke. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, wow. Okay. Come on, let me get some of that health back from throwing
you
down.
These guys are chumps. Give me something bigger.
If you have the... Oh, whoops. Why did he explode? I guess neon gas and smoke don't mix together very well.
Okay.
Oh, jeez.
Okay,
they're still shooting me.
Bigger.
Who's shooting me? Okay. Stop. Give me that life back. Getting life... Oh. Let me get him. Nice. Come on. Oh my gosh. Could I miss any more? Okay. Keep him still.
Smoke break.
All right. Good.
That should come in handy.
Get that life. Yes, it will. Whoop. There we go. Nice drive. And we're going up really high. I'm always amazed how people can build buildings like this. This is pretty neat. Oh, they don't even know I'm here. Fools. And you go down. And give me those invincibility frames. Yes, baby. I love those invincibility frames. Take that wall down. Oh, jeez. Oh, come on, there we go. So yeah, that's pretty nice. We get life back from the whatever that ability you want to call it, is when we throw them down. It's pretty nice. Don't have to worry about it. We get a little life back. I'll just hit you. You're not dead yet. Alright, now you're dead. Take some of this.
Looking for that?
Give me some smoke.
Fetch, you're a lifesaver.
Thank you, Fetchy. How fetching of you.
Hey,
oh, jeez, helicopters.
This would be a good time for some backup.
Ask and ye shall receive.
Hey, Eugene.
Eugene? Man. You sure know how to level a playing field.
It's good to have friends in high places.
Yes, it is. Nice. We got a whole little gaggle. How awesome. And I got to get rid of those helicopters, because they're not actually going to do it for me. Or, well, they kind of, but it takes a long time. I hate fighting helicopters. Unless it's with video power. Video power! It just takes so long. Actually, I think... Ooh, nice. I think I can get up higher, though. Or can I not? I know I can, but I don't know if I can do it right now. Alright. Yeah. Oh, jeez. Whoa. Let's get up higher. That'll make getting the... helicopters a little easier.
My angels!
Easy on the trash talk, Eugene!
I know, right, Eugene? You get just a little bit of power and you start going ham.
Yo, D, come here. You gotta come see this.
Power really shows people's true colors. My will... Where's the rest of it? Jeez, oh, come on. Lead that... There we go. Lead it. Damn it, didn't lead it right. Gosh, there's still quite a few helicopters going around. Yeah, this is one of the more annoying parts of this level, just trying to get the helicopters. Because you only have smoke, which isn't the most proficient helicopter killing method. Mainly because the helicopters, nice, don't stay still. But if you aimed better, it might, there we go.
Another launch pad for you.
Nice, got them all. Cool beans. Thank you. And I'm off. Woo! Oh, good.
Oh, smartest
good
move
thinking.
I've seen all day.
Give me some of that video, baby. Yummy.
Pull out the new tricks.
Bam.
Oh.
All right.
Hell yeah.
Lots
of
guys.
The whole roof's armor plated.
Let me try the high beams on it.
You sure you can cut through?
Yeah. If you and Teen Angel there can keep the dupes off my ass.
Fear not, or I shall
you. Fine, I'll keep the goofs off your ass. Uh-oh, looks
how's
like we got
fetch?
A white knight
don't
over
rush
here.
Me, D. I don't like being rushed. Almost there.
Kind of a waste of a blast, but it's okay. I won't be using it.
Got it. All yours, D. All
right.
You go inside.
Time to break this bad boy open.
You
woo!
Keep these guys off your back.
Time to slam down. Nice. Impact engaged.
Oh, good. You're here.
That'd be great if there's like a little dinner table, a rose, a couple
Rowe,
candles lit,
testing you,
nice bottle of wine.
You assembled your little bag of tricks. Very impressive.
Yeah? I know all about what you did, too. Using Hank to set up that crash? Making Eugene and Fetch look like monsters just so you could look like the hero?
Someone has to protect the conduits.
Protect?
In the 7 years since my DUP took over conduit oversight from the military, not a single one of our kind has been killed.
No, of course not. Could you just hunt them down and lock them up?
Yes, in Curtin K. Protected from the mobs that want to kill conduits. It's what's best for them, whether they know it or not.
You just make that decision for them, huh?
Some decisions are too important. I've seen how people look at you in the street. Do you know how rare it is? For the powerless to embrace a conduit? You've got...
Cole was embraced quite a lot.
That popularity.
Delson's not the first, dude.
Trust to convince them that the only solution to the bioterrorist menace is my DUP.
Did you just call me a menace a while
that
ago?
That over half the conduits who died in the bloodbath 7 years ago were killed by the military. If they regain control, what makes you think things won't return to those good old days?
No. No, I'm gonna expose you. And your deception. And then we'll see who the real protector is.
That would be a death sentence for all conduits. I can't let you do that.
And I won't let you stop me.
I guess that's the old decision. Freedom versus security and protection. You know, you get that freedom, but you get... With the freedom comes the choice, but also comes a lack of protection. But with that lack of choice, you get freedom. So I guess you really just gotta weigh your options. What do you want? And I'm gonna kick her in the gut again, because I'm a good person. It'd be nice if Eugene or Fetch came in here to help me. Where the hell are they? Whoa, that's really cool looking. Where the hell are Eugene and Fetch, though? Seriously, like, they could be in here helping me. Well, the swords were going nuts there. Instead, I gotta fight her by myself, but whatever. Okay, well, they're having a hard time hitting her, because she's so tiny. Oh, and now I missed my chance. Okay, come on, get her. Ugh, come on. Yep, gotta go back. Why would she have any source of anything? She should have absolutely nothing. It shouldn't be that hard to not have any video around. And neon gases should be kind of easy, too. The only one that could maybe be hard is smoke, maybe? Even then, though, I think you could probably find a way to not have any smoke in an environment. She's just really bad at choosing her final fights. Okay, come on. Right, there we go. Nice. Let's get a little more. Yeah, since we have video, though, it's a lot easier to take her down. I mean, she's still pretty hard. I mean, not, I wouldn't say super hard, but video's just got such good missiles. Nice. Because they come in threes. And let's bring her some heaven and hell. Taste my justice, baby!
Okay. You want my power?
Why does it have to be through her glove? Wouldn't it have to be through skin contact?
You got it.
Seems like she should have taken her glove off. But whatever.
7 years ago,
My unit was there to save lives from a new threat. Conduits.
They're Sean.
With powers that no one understood. They had the power to kill. And the power to transform some of us into conduits, too. I found another survivor. She tailed me as I made my way back to the safety of my battalion. Together, we traveled through a lawless city that wanted us dead because of what we now were. Every day, people joined the lynch mob, horrified by the thought of conduits hiding among them.
Where's Evil Cole when you need him?
Hurt
he could
no
have solved
one.
All these problems.
But they could only see us as monsters. When military order finally asserted itself, they treated us as the threat. I was conduit. I was military. But I couldn't be both. So I made another option. It was the only way. By bringing in that first conduit alive, I'd earned the government's trust. And that was just the start. They funded the creation of the D.U.P., thinking we were just freaks hunting down other freaks. But that wasn't it. I was going to save as many conduits as I could. If my kind were going to live, it'd be behind the walls of Curtin K. Seven years, I've kept them safe. Me. I won't let anyone undo that. Not the government. Not the army. Not you.
7 years, all you've done is keep them locked up. You just took away their freedom.
So tell me, what would you do? Just throw open the gates at Curtin K Station? Let them all free?
You bet your ass I would.
The world hasn't changed in the past 7 years. Inside, the conduits are safe. They're alive. You turn them out, they'd all be dead inside a week. So tell me, who's the savior? And who's the monster? This is what you wanted. You win. We both have the same power. Only difference is, I've had 7 years to practice.
Yeah, Delson, that was kind of a bad move on your part. 7 years. Oh, God, she made a giant spider. Yeah, we got nothing. We can't do shit. We're pretty fucked. Oh, jeepers. Delson, you did not think this through.
Get some help! Can't do anything!
Oh, Eugene's gonna come in here and fight for us.
Okay, Delson.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
I'll see what I can find.
No, how did you learn anything? This is Delson's story. Eugene helping would just be stupid. I don't get this part. Like, where the hell are Fetch and Eugene? Like, Eugene helps a little bit. Actually, he does help quite a bit. Without him, we would have lost. But I don't understand why he doesn't come in here and help us fight Augustine with Fetch. Okay, maybe he's too big with the angel. Fine. But he can make tinier angels to come in here.
Thanks. See if you can find some more.
I don't know. And Fetch could certainly join the fight. I don't know. I thought it was kind of a contrived reason for why it had to be just Delson. Because it could have all helped, but whatever. Alright. We got rock armor. We're turning into the thing. Not particularly useful for battle, unfortunately. The boulder dash. And actually, oops. We can go ahead and immediately level up. So now that we got the boulder dash, let's see. We can strength the stone. We'll take less damage. We'll take 20% less damage when using concrete. And endless dash. So now we'll get endless dash. So we can run forever. So, that's it. So now we can just run forever and we take less damage. So, yep. You don't have to get the rest of the shards. But it's probably a good idea to get just enough so that you can level up maybe a couple of your abilities. So I would recommend you level up the damage. The ability to take less damage, because that's actually really helpful. So fortunately, though, we cannot really do anything to Augustine, because it hurts regular enemies, but it won't really hurt her, since she's on a giant spider. It is actually pretty fun, though. We actually run relatively fast. I don't think we can run as fast as,
I can't catch that!
Yeah, I don't think we run as fast as Fetch does with the endless run, but we run really fast, and I think it does damage to enemies, too. Nice. This is what we wanted, though. The shrapnel. And let's level that up real quick. Extended shrapnel. Now we can fire for longer periods of time. Now where's the... Okay, I don't think we get that. Alright. So, yep. Her shrapnel fire was... The concrete fire is actually really pretty actually decent. We've already taken off quite a chunk of her health. It's like a rock... It's like a machine gun. And as you can see, it's done quite a bit of damage just right... just by itself. It's really cool though when you use the boulder dash in the air. It reminds me of the Goron spin, because you turn into like a huge spinning top and you go, woo. A really good place to hide from her shots is right behind trees. For some reason, her shot... Okay. Normally, that might have been the wrong tree, but normally you hide behind the trees and it's good. Just keep shooting her in the cankles. You don't have to worry about running out of concrete because you're constantly getting... You'll get it refilled by itself, which is nice. Interesting thing is, though, the only way to get concrete power in the game is to take it away from, D.U.P. troops. Yeah, you can't just take concrete out of the ground like you would think. You have to steal it from D.U.P. troops. So once you beat them, you just absorb their concrete ability. Which is a little weak. It's kind of weird. Okay, so here we got our hover ability, which is... I mean, you can use it. It's okay. Actually, what I mean is it's not particularly useful in this fight, per se, but... She has probably one of the best hovers in the game, from what I remember, because you can get a double lift and then a triple lift. It is actually pretty damn good to go 1, 2, 3. I mean, look how high I just got there. I mean, it shoots you off, too. It just blasts you off. It's actually pretty good. It reminds me a lot of Cole's ice jump in Infamous 2 when you got the ice ability with Quo. So yeah, it's pretty much just exactly like that. Except it's just on the jump. It's not its own designated button or ability. It's just a regular jump, which is pretty nice. So just keep whittling away at her life. So yeah, it's actually a pretty easy fight. Especially if you get all the rest of the shards. If you get the rest of the shards, you can upgrade all your abilities. And it's just fairly easy. I like that jump, though.
That's all I'm gonna need.
One thing that's kind of unfortunate is, though, she doesn't get her own Karma Bomb attack, though. That would have been cool to see, like, a Karma Bomb where we cause a huge earthquake or we summon a giant spider made of rocks. But we do get her rockets, though. Her rockets are pretty damn good. The bigger D.U.P. guys use these against us. The really chunky ones. So yeah, we can just throw rockets in there. Oh, jeez. We only get... I think we might... Oh, jeez. Let me see if I can upgrade them. Yep. So the last one... Okay, yeah. Requires Quanquit. So yeah, that's all the abilities. I think. I feel like I'm missing one. Yeah, I think this might be the ability we're missing. There's some... Let me see. Am I missing an ability? Because I think I'm pretty sure that the shard should completely be drained. Okay, maybe we don't have everything. I don't know. I should have no more shards at this point. But maybe there's still one more ability if I remember. Oh, jeez. I died. Just trying to hide behind a tree. That didn't work out very well. But yeah, though. This fight isn't too hard, even though I died. Her missiles are actually pretty damn good. They go in like a huge wave pattern, which is actually pretty nice. I'm not really sure. I don't really understand completely how we get more. We just kind of do get more. If you want to avoid them too, you can just strafe back and forth. That works if you can't find the tree. Okay, sometimes, usually the tree would protect me all the time, but now it's not doing it at all. It's kind of annoying. So try and hit him. You know, this isn't working. Maybe you should try something different. I mean, How long are you going to keep using this spider thing until you figure out, hey, you know what, this isn't really effective. He just keeps hitting me with my own abilities. He's kicking your ass, and you've had these for 7 years, and you can't just beat him instantly? Okay. Hide right here. It is kind of weird, though, how we can't get concrete powers unless we suck it from the dupes. I mean, I guess that makes sense a little bit, because if you could just get concrete powers anywhere, then you could constantly be healing yourself. But it's still kind of weird, though. Maybe there could have been, like, little patches of concrete that just had a little more concrete ability that we could steal from instead of just getting them from the dupes. But I guess the dupes work just as fine, too. It's just a little weird, that's all. Oh, yeah, nice. Rocks protect me. Yeah, though, if you used a rock in the air, though, you look like a Goron spinning, which is actually a pretty cool little detail. Oh, crap. Ran your cankles. Oh, geez, better bail. Oh, nice. Just keep hitting her. I like her regular fire shard, though, her regular shrapnel attack. I like that attack a lot. It's really good. It does a lot. It deals with regular enemies really quickly. Ooh. Right in the bun. Right in the back. Oh, jeez. Oh, gosh. No, don't die, Dan. No. Don't die. Come on. Get some life back. Oh, my gosh. Oh, jeez. I said this fight wasn't hard, and then I proceeded to get killed. Oh, gosh. I gotta do all that over again. Yeah, okay, this fight can be a little annoying. For some reason, the trees aren't protecting me like they did in my practice runs. Alright. If I die again, I'll just off-screen the way I went. Oh, jeez. Ah, come on. She's really not that hard. I'm just being stupid. Alright, just go underneath her. There we go. You can't do anything when I'm behind. Never mind. Hold on. Okay, there we go. Alright, come on. I'm gonna get you this time. Get you right in the face. Yeah, if I just use the missiles, though, that will take her out really quickly. Just a couple of well-shot... Just a couple of shot missiles right in the freaking stupid face. Turn. Just start side running. Oh, yeah. Come on. That attack looks actually pretty cool. And then she's gonna turn into the snake. Yep. Alright. Turn into the Goron. There we go. Nice and safe for a minute. Need some more missiles. Come on, missiles. There we go. Hit you in the face. I didn't do that much damage. I don't know if you can do more damage to Augustine if she's, like, revealed herself. I don't think you can. Alright. Oh. Thank goodness. You definitely want to get the 20% less damage, because that's actually really helpful, especially on hard mode. Oh, jeez. Whoa! There's my protective trees. Right here. I want to hide right behind here. This is a good place to hide. You can't really do that on the other side, though. But you can definitely do it right here. Oh, she still has more? Jeez, I thought she was done. Alright, jump. And then here comes the snake. Why don't you try other animals, like the penguin? I'd be intimidated by a giant rock penguin. Okay, she's almost done for. Oh, jeez. What really sucks is if she just starts hitting you, you just kind of get stuck sometimes. I better hide, she's probably going to summon... Okay, no, she's not doing the missiles. That does she's going to shoot me with missiles. Okay, don't you dare die. Gotcha. So yeah, not a hard fight, but I was being stupid, so that's how I died twice. Oh, right on the keys. Looks like you're out of luck, Augustine.
Yeah, I'm told that hurts.
Ooh, we zoomed right into his eyes. What a zinger.
When the dust finally settled, all you could see of Augustine were her eyes peering out from that concrete shell. The rage that had filled them moments earlier was now replaced by fear. We dismantled the fortress she had built, the army she had raised, the future she had planned. The entire world was about to know that she had failed. Taken down by a gamer, a junkie, and a small town delinquent. The crowds cheered as Augustine was hauled away. Before all this, no one would have imagined that humans and conduits could coexist. And now I was the guy kicking off the Second Age. Oh, and those conduits who'd spent years locked inside the walls of Curtain K, they were soon to be free once again, to live their own lives, to choose their own futures. As for me, I'd gotten what I came for. And now I had a promise to keep.
Ethan, you're here. It's gone.
Yeah.
They're all gone.
A promise is a promise, right?
And the others?
I just got here. You're my first stop. Comish. We take care of our own, right?
Where's Reggie?
Reggie, Reggie saved me.
And there we go, viewers. That is Infamous Second Sons. So yeah, that was really fun. I had a really great time. This is a really good game. I'd say it's my second favorite out of the Infamous series. It goes Infamous 2, Infamous Second Sons, or Infamous 3, and then Infamous 1. It's really good. I can't really say anything else than that, except I really enjoyed the game. I like Delson for the most part. He's a pretty nice character, I think. I don't like him as much as Cole, but I've had two games to become attached to Cole, so that's no knock against Delson, because I think he's still a pretty good character. But yeah, though, I really enjoyed the game. I enjoyed the powers. The thing is, though, we have Concrete now, so after the credits roll, you can go ahead and go back to the main game and do whatever side missions you didn't do with the Concrete powers, and they're pretty fun, but there's just no incentive if you've done everything like me to do anything else, so it's a little bit of a shame, but that's just how it goes. Other than that, though, I think it was a little funny, though, when Delson says, like, this is the first time conduits have ever lived in peace. It's like, well, no, to be fair, Cole kind of did that when he sacrificed himself and the people of New Marais. Oh, Sly Cooper. The people of New Marais made a monument for him. But only the people of New Marais, I think, knew what he did. So he's probably right in the fact that more people in Seattle know than maybe New Marais did. Other than that, though, I had a really good time. We might come back to the world of Infamous in the future, because there's kind of an additional game with Fetch where you hear her story. So we hear, like, right after she's been caught at Curtain K, after she just killed her brother, she has her own storyline, and I haven't seen that yet. So we could probably check that out. I might even do that blind. I might be interested in just doing that blind and seeing how we don't know what's going to happen. I usually like to do things play, but, you know, it could be a fun little thing where I don't know what's going to happen and you don't know either. We just experience it together. Anyways, so I'm just going to let the credits roll, and that's it. So I'll see you when I start my brand new LP. So this is me, Yohhamgambal. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and I hope you enjoyed this third look into the world of Infamous. See you next time.